right, guys, welcome in to the Gospel Music Jukebox this morning. We are going to wear a crown, amen, praise God, and a robe, and then we're going to cast our crown at the feet of Jesus. My goodness, my goodness, my goodness. Hey, got food for thought for you this morning right here on the Gospel Music Jukebox, praise God. All right, think about this for just a moment, if you would. Did Jesus ever get angry? You know, that question come up a lot. You know, people say, well, you know, anger's of the devil. Well, now, not all anger, as we're going to learn right here this morning on the jukebox. Hey, guys, listen, Jesus clearly displayed anger during his earthly life. He really did. The primary examples is his response to those who were making a profit by exchanging money and selling animals at the temple. Check out Matthew, book of Matthew there, chapter 21, verses 12 and 13. Also, you want to look in Mark, chapter 11, verses 15 through 18, as well as John, chapter 2, verses 13 through 22. Hey, food for thought. Did Jesus ever get angry? And if we're to strive to be Christ-like, then are we to get angry? Are we a good anger now, as you're going to see? So hang in there, hang with us. We'll be right back. And thank you once again, my friends, for stopping by right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox.
This ain't no house of the blues, it's a house of good news. It ain't no place to break down, it's a place to break through. This ain't no place for doubt, it's a place to sing and shout. So get out of your pew, put on your dancing shoes. This ain't no house of the blues. Lay your burden down. Hey, crank the music loud. Forget about your hurts. Endless house and church. 'Cause when your praise goes up, the glory will come down. Let go of your fear and dry your tears. God's gonna turn it around. This ain't no house of the blues, it's a house of good news. It ain't no place to break down, it's a place to break through. This ain't no place for doubt, it's a place to sing and shout. So get out of your pew, put on your dancing shoes. This ain't no house of the blues.
This ain't no house.
Amen. Praise God. Hey, now, if you look in the book of Matthew, chapter 21, verses 12 and 13, along with Mark, chapter 11, verse 15 through 18, and John, chapter 2, verses 13 through 22, you're going to see clearly that Jesus, well, he got angry, but he sinned not. Here's the key. I want to talk to you about one other occasion that Jesus, you know, you may have heard this preached before, but Jesus asked the religious leaders if it was, you know, okay to heal a person on the Sabbath day. Now, when they would not answer, listen, we're told he looked around at them with anger. And there in the book of Mark, chapter 3, verse 5, jump over there and ask God to write his word upon the tablet of your heart, my friend. Hey, before healing a man, his anger centered on the attitudes of the religious teachers who claimed to know the law yet cared more about themselves than whether a person was healed or not. So yes, Jesus was angry at times, yet he did not sin. Look in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 15 this morning as we're sharing food for thought. Now likewise, believers in Christ are taught, be angry and sin not. Look in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26. Now listen, while anger is often viewed as a completely negative emotion. Now friends, there are times a person can be angry for appropriate reasons. In the case of Jesus, his anger was the result of an ungodly attitude and actions by those around him. In addition, now listen, God the Father often displayed anger in the Old Testament when people sinned against him and when injustice took place, you know, in the world. Still today, when Christians see sinful actions taking place, especially by those who claim to be religious leaders, it should cause anger. Why? Well, because such anger reflects the attitude of Christ. Yes, in those situations. Look at Philippians 2, chapter 2, verse 5. Just giving you food for thought, I really want you to dive into the Word of God, replay this archive, and get in there and understand why you see men of God. I know I get a lot of questions asked in the email and on my Facebook account. You know, why are you mad? You know, I'm not mad at nobody, and I'm not mad at one individual person. Now, it does. I get mad, but I keep it in check. That's what I want you to do today. I want you to realize, listen, it makes me mad when somebody tells me they love me and God put them with me and they're going to help us in this ministry, and then they block me off their Facebook page, block me off their radio program. Now, come on, that makes me mad. It hurts my heart. It makes me mad because they are falsely accusing me. You understand? They're not wanting nobody to be healed, see, or they wouldn't do that. Now, the truth is, you wouldn't do that. You would pray it through. You'd pray about it. And you would do what's right. Watch what happens here. You see, as you get into Philippians chapter 2, verse 5. And then, listen, anger that reflects the anger of Christ requires two aspects. Now, I want you to hold on to this. First, it must be properly motivated. In other words, you know, being angry because you simply don't get your way in a situation, hey, that's the wrong kind of anger. And that anger will get you in trouble. But now, religious hypocrisy or injustice of poverty or oppression, they're proper godly reasons to become angry, but you sin not. You see, now, remember, I told you too. That was the first. Here's the second aspect required for anger to reflect Christ's anger. You see, to reflect Christ's anger is to act appropriately when we're angry. Now listen, if you paid attention and go back and read, you'll see that Jesus healed a man even when he was angry at those standing around him, revealing that we are called to do good even when we're upset. Now, in addition, the passage referring to Jesus turning over tables in the temple showed his anger properly expressed to remove people who were, well, breaking God's law by making a profit from the system of, you know, animal offerings rather than focusing on worship of the Lord. Now, do you think God's pleased with people today that are selling the gospel? What do you think? Do you think he's angry? Do you think the Lord's angry today? Listen, he says, if my people who are called by my name would turn. I'm telling you, God's talking to you today, church. You see, further, the anger of Jesus, it did not result in, let's say, like a long-term grudge. It didn't. Instead, his anger was an emotion that, well, resulted in the proper action. Now, today, believers must seek the same response. Listen, anger left unchecked is wrongly motivated. And it can result in a long-term unforgiveness that, well, it causes you problems until you repent of it and make things right in your life with God. Let me just say this to you. As you take food for thought, and as you research these scriptures and you pray and ask God to write his word upon the tablet of your heart, my friend, Jesus did become angry on some occasions. And if we're to strive to be Christ-like, we're going to get angry. But keep it in check and do the right thing. And if, as you've seen, Jesus was angry at those religious leaders. They were more worried about themselves than they was whether anybody got healed or touched. And that's what's going on today, the same garbage. But let me tell you something. Let's uplift Jesus. Uplift Jesus. Listen, you can be angry, but sin not. And I'm angry. I'm angry at these men of God. They're men of God. Listen, you may say they're not because, you know, they may not be doing things you want them to do. But let me tell you something. When God's called somebody, they're men or women of God. And they may not live like you want them or like I think they should, or they may not be doing the things that we think they should be doing. But we should encourage them to obey God. I may not understand it, but obey God. But now, how do we know who our brothers are? People often get mad at me in the wrong aspect, the wrong way, when I say everyone is not my brother. Everyone is not my sister. How can I say that? Well, see, when you keep your anger in check and you know that there's a good anger and there's a wrong anger, there is a Christ-like anger. There is, and the Word of God will show it to you. And I'm striving to be Christ-like. What about you today, my friends? You see, Jesus did become angry on many occasions. Yet he was not known as an angry person. You know, he wasn't remembered for his anger. You see, his anger was not an excuse for sinful actions. If you pay attention to people today, they'll use their anger for sinful actions. That's the wrong kind of anger. That's anger unchecked, unrepented. That's flesh. But Jesus, rather than using it for sinful, what did he do? For positive actions that helped others and honored God. Even when he was angry, and if you back up and look, if you've got your Bibles with you, you want to grab that as you go into the book of Mark. You really want to pay attention right there in Mark chapter 3, verse 5, where his anger was centered on the attitudes of those religious teachers who claimed to know the law, yet cared more about themselves than whether a person was healed or not. Food for thought. We love you. We'll see you next time right here on the Gospel Music Jukebox. Once again, it wouldn't let me share the program, and I cannot open my chat room. So if you were stop by to hang out with us, we'd appreciate it if you'd just share the program. Tell your friends and family what's going on, that, hey, God's not dead. He's alive, and he's working actively in the lives of his children. But if you've been blocked on, my wife was blocked the other day by a man of God that she loves dearly. And I really want you to pray that he wouldn't do that. Even though he could be mad at me, that's fine. But nobody in my family has done nothing to him. And he shouldn't do that. He should continue to let his light shine and minister to them. You know, I think it's sad when men of God, I mean, why are you on there? To be seen or heard? Or are you on there to preach the gospel? If I'm so sick, if they think I'm so wrong, why would they block me? Why would they not try to minister to me? The wrong kind of anger, my friend. Be good. Know that God loves you and we love you. And we're going to continue to pray for you as we step out to do what God has called us to do. Be careful what and who you listen to. If somebody is not telling you the truth, if it does not line up with the Word of God, their life, their action, their anger, their love, if it don't line up with the Word of God, hey, if I was you, I wouldn't listen to garbage. It belongs in a garbage can. Be blessed. We'll see you next time right here on the Gospel Music Jukebox. We just wanted to share some food for thought. So get in those scriptures, get in the Word of God, and be blessed. Amen. God bless y'all. If anybody gets to check this out, please know I couldn't share it and that I can't open the chat room, so I have no way of knowing. But know that we love you, and we're going to continue to encourage you to be Christ-like. Strive to be Christ-like. Walk being led by the Spirit of God, my friends. We love you, and I do apologize. I've been working on this old computer, so please continue to pray for me that I get things running smoother and better. We're just leaving it in God's hands. Because why? Jesus is alive, my friends. God bless.